Google has just released its own AI chatbot and ChatGPT competitor. The Google AI tool is called Google Bard. And if unsuccessful though, it could finally mean the downfall of Google. More on that later. But what is Google Bard? It's also an AI-based language generation tool based off its AI language model, Google Lamda AI, which was released 2 years ago. This breaking AI news came to light when Sundar Pichai, the CEO of Google, recently announced the upcoming launch of this new AI-powered chatbot, Bard AI. In a blog post, Pichai said that the chatbot will be available to trusted testers starting now already, with plans to make it accessible to the public in the coming weeks. So how to use Google Bard AI? I'll show you in just a minute, but first, Bard AI is built on the same technology as ChatGPT, a large language model released by AI research company OpenAI in late November. These models are trained on massive amounts of data from the internet, providing them with the ability to generate compelling responses to user prompts. The goal of Bard AI is to bring together the vast knowledge of the world and the intelligence, power, and creativity of these large language models. Watch this video to see the main competitor for Google AI, ChatGPT, and to see how it works. The launch of Google ChatGPT competitor, Bard AI, comes at a time when Google's core product, that is online search, is facing its greatest threat in years. In the 2 months since ChatGPT's release, the chatbot has been utilized to generate essays, stories, song lyrics, even make money, as well as answer questions that one might have previously searched for on Google. This overwhelming attention on ChatGPT has reportedly prompted Google's management team to declare a code red situation for its search business, with some experts claiming that Google may only be a year or two away from complete disruption due to the rise of AI. Microsoft, which has confirmed plans to invest in OpenAI and ChatGPT, has already announced that it will integrate the ChatGPT tool into some of its products. It is also rumored to be planning to incorporate it into its search engine, Bing, Google's number one search rival. The technology behind Google Bard AI has been around for some time, but it was not widely available to the public until now. Google confirmed that Google Lambda AI will power Bard. Last year, a former Google engineer claimed that Google Lambda AI was sentient, though these claims were widely criticized in the AI community. In his blog post, Pichai provided an example of how to use Google Bard AI. He asked the chatbot to explain new discoveries made by NASA's James Webb Space Telescope in a way that a 9-year-old might find interesting. Bard responded with conversational bullet points. Never mind that part of the response was actually inaccurate and caused the stocks of Google's parent company, Alphabet, to plummet upon release of this demo. Google Bard AI can also be used for a variety of purposes, from planning a friend's baby shower to getting lunch ideas based on what's in your fridge. Pichai also announced that AI-powered tools will soon begin to roll out on Google's flagship search tool. He said that these features will provide users with a quick and easy way to understand complex information and perspectives from the web. Hopefully, we'll be able to download Google Bard app to our phones soon in a more superior way than we can with ChatGPT in this video. I'm looking forward to seeing the Google Bard search interface and how to use Google Bard AI. It will certainly be interesting to watch the Google ChatGPT competitor, the battle of Bard versus ChatGPT, Google Search versus Bing, and ultimately Google versus Microsoft. Will Google again reign supreme, or is this finally Google's downfall? Well, with AI technology doubling every 6 months, significantly outperforming Moore's law, it won't be long before we find out. Did you know that you can actually kind of cheat and already incorporate ChatGPT into Google search? We'll watch this quick video to learn how. So click that now and I'll see you there.